I don't want to start speaking about DDM. Because if I speak about it, then I may not teach. But maybe I'll give you some few hints. The first thing, DDM has been in service for now 19 years. And we have trained classes, students, leaders all over the country. Almost every passing year, we graduate an average of 1,200
students.
And we are trying to raise up a generation where God will say that I have found a man who has a heart like mine. If you look at David, David sinned like any other. David sinned even more than Saul. But as we speak, he is one of the few people we are sure that are going to inherit eternal life. Now, we are trying to raise such a people. And we do that through teaching. So we have a course of around 10 units. And they are intentionally organized such that when one has gone through them, such a person can either inherit heaven or hell, but knowledgeably. I hope I'm clear. This is what I believe. If you have gone through DDM, even when you go to hell, you will say, I knew. And I normally tell them that when you get there, tell them what we told you. I truly believe a knowledgeable person, even in hell, is going to be purposeful. You'll find those crying, and he will tell them, cry with intention, because we are going to cry for the rest of our lives. Now that's about DDM. Seriously, I cannot speak about DDM. We can't manage. So today, remember we are in the Inner Man Conference. And this conference, predominantly, we are speaking about the inner man. I really thank my pastor, Bishop Stephen Senfuma. I thank the pastoral team. I thank them for having chosen me to speak to you this afternoon. My name is James Mutunzi. And I'm a member of this church. In fact, I've been in this church for 22 years. God has been good. I am a married man. My wife is Judith, seated there. And we have 5 children. And we all love the Lord. So now to the word. We are going to be speaking about giving accountability. And let us turn to 2 Corinthians. The chapter is 5. And the verse is 10. 2 Corinthians. The chapter is 5. And the verse is 10. It reads, "For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that each one may receive the things done in the body, according to what he has done, whether good or bad."
Abakolinse chokubiri esule yokutano linyore kumi. Kubanga fefe na chitu gwanira okulabisiwa Kristo wali saire misango. Buli muntu awewe beyakola mumbiri ngabwe yakola obabirunji obabibi.
Now, one thing I want you to understand, that the choice of the words that are used in the Bible are not there by mistake. But then if you look at the other translations, like the Luganda translation, it tries to water down what was written in this scripture. The Bible says, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ. The word I want you to underline is must. That means no one is going to survive or dodge that place. And then the question comes, when? In this same scripture, they tell us after we have gotten out of our bodies. That means you were there, but in two. The Bible says that a time is coming when you are going to get out of that body. And after getting out of that body, the Bible tells us you are going to appear at the judgment seat of Christ. And the Bible tells us that after that, you are going to be rewarded. The question comes, rewarded how? We are going to be rewarded depending on what we are doing in the body. When we read this scripture, I want to present to you the God you have known for long, but now I want to present him as a judge. We have known about him on many, many occasions. There are very many things that are written about him. And as the church, we have deliberately chosen to choose what is easy to think about. We want to look at him as a father, as a friend, the closest helper. But he is also a judge. When we go to 1 Peter and the verse is 1 and the verse is 17, the Bible tells us, and if you call on the Father, who without partiality judges according to each one's work, conduct yourself through the time of your sojourning in fear, knowing that you are not redeemed with corruptible things.
Amen.
1 Peter, the chapter 1 and the verse 17. So here the Bible is telling us that the Father is a judge. And this judge is going to judge in justice. He's going to judge without partiality. And for some of you who are ministering, maybe let's turn to James. Though this one speaks about teachers, but still there is something I want to build in you. The Bible tells us this. James chapter 3 and the verses 1. It says this: my brethren, let not many of you become teachers, knowing that we shall receive a stricter judgment.
Amen.
Here we are talking about God the judge. And then the question is, who is he going to judge? Where are we reading in 2 Corinthians
5:10?
The Bible told us that he's going to judge that one He's going to judge that one.
Agenda kusala oyo.
Who is going to come out of the body?
Oyo agenda okuva mu mubiri gwaffe.
And I want you to understand that the one that is being referred to there is the inner man. Is your spirit man. And that's the real you. Unfortunately, we have taken time to care about the body. Yet we very well know that the body is not going to sit anywhere for judgment. But we have done everything we can to cater for the body, yet the body has no assignment hereafter. But when you read in Ecclesiastes, the chapter is 12. And the verse is 7. The Bible says, then the dust will return to the earth as it was, and the spirit will turn to God who gave it.
Amen.
Bible one to gamba.
The Bible tells us.
Tia wonno mubiri cheguliva gudda mutaka mwe gwava.
Then the body will go back to the dust where it came from.
Omoyo nadda yeri katonde ya mugaba.
And the spirit will go back to the Lord who gave it.
Na ikatsyangu nyo okulowoza.
But it's very easy to think.
Tia omoyo no bwana dayeri katonda.
That when the spirit goes back to God.
Katonda agenda kugwa muchifuba.
God is going to embrace you.
Ali okakwanirizo yingira okola mu butagwa.
Welcome you to enter eternal life.
Na
but I want you to understand it. The Bible has told us that when we go before, it's a day to give accountability. A day of being judged. A day of giving accountability. The question comes, have you ever prepared yourself for that day? We are now entering in the Christmas season. Everyone is preparing themselves for that Christmas day. But it's one day. I've seen people have prepared themselves for the weddings. They buy this. They buy this. They prepare that. When they're preparing for the wedding. And then all people are no longer peaceful because of the wedding. They're preparing for the wedding. But it's one day. The Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes 12. And then the body will go back to the dust where it came from. And the spirit will go to God who gave it. And to reach there, you have to give accountability.
Now I want to pick you a bit. When we look at God and the creation, God never created anyone for anything. God created us for specific things. And if you follow the Bible, God made man in two phases. In Genesis chapter 1 and the verses 27, the Bible tells us, and God made man in his image. So there we see that it is the spirit man that was created in Genesis chapter
1.
When we go to chapter
2,
another part of man is created. The Bible tells us, if we read from verse
4,
I beg those with the Luganda Bibles, please follow as I read in English. The Bible says this. This is the history of the heaven and the earth. When they were created in that day, the Lord God made the earth and the heavens. Before any plants of the field was in the earth, and before any herbs of the field had grown, for the Lord God had not caused it to rain on the earth, and there was no man to till the ground. Let's first pause there a bit.
So let's come out.
Here the Bible is explaining that God did not let the rain fall. He did not let the dew fall. Because he knew if the dew fell, if it rained, then the plants would blossom. And he gives reason. I did not do that because there was no one to tend the garden. He's giving reason why he's going to do 6 and 7. Now in verse 6 he says this. Remember, we are in Genesis chapter 2 and now the verse is 6. It says, but as the mist went up from the earth and watered the whole face of the ground, and the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed in his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living being.
Amen.
The Bible is telling us this.
Bible yatugamba chino.
We are seeing
tulaba
that the spirit man is created in chapter 1.
Nti omuto womoyo atondebwa musule soka.
And God gives reason
era Katonda wensonga
why he's putting flesh on the spirit man.
Rachi atekako omubiri ku muntu ono womoyo.
He's saying
akamba
that there is a garden to look after.
Nti waliwo ennimiro yokulabirira.
There is work to do.
Waliwo omulimu gwokola.
There is responsibility.
Waliwo obuvunanyizibwa.
And the Bible tells
us.
And that's why he formed the body of the man and placed with him the inner man, and he became a living being. If you are still with me, say amen. Praise the Lord. So here we see that even the first man came here intentionally. He had something to do. I am here to tell you that even you are not here by mistake. It doesn't matter how you came, but God brought you here for a reason. Now the problem is many of us do not know that reason. We are in a generation where people are serving God. They sleep tired. They wake up tired in the pretext of serving God. But when they are not sure, what they are doing is what God created them to do. Now when we go to Jeremiah, the chapter is 1 and the verse is 5. This is what the Bible says. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you, and I ordained you a prophet to the nations. Here God was telling Jeremiah. He was telling him, Jeremiah, even before you were in the womb of your mother, I knew you. What do you pick from that verse? Number one, God knew Jeremiah even before he was in his mother's womb. Remember, the flesh is begot by the womb. So here the Bible is telling us that God knew Jeremiah even before he had put on flesh, and he assigned him a responsibility which God expects him to fulfill. I want to tell you, brethren, that God knew you even before you were in your mother's womb. That God knew your inner man even before you were in the outer man, and assigned you a duty. The generation we are in.
Omulembe gwetulimu.
People choose
abantu balondawo
to do what they want for God.
Okukola ekyebaagala okukolera Katonda.
Instead of doing what God wants them to do.
Mu kifo ky'okukola Katonda ky'abeetazze okukola.
In other words,
mu ngeri emu,
we would rather do the nice and simple.
Twandikoze ebirungi ate ebyanguwa.
Though not useful.
Yadde nga tebigasa.
And leave the hard but necessary.
Netulekawo ebikaluba ate nga byetaagisibwa.
Which is the will of God for your life.
Okwo nga kwe kwagala kwa Katonda olw'obulamu bwo.
I hope it isn't hard teaching. I hope we are following.
Ndowooza tugoberera.
Listen to this.
Wuliriza kino.
We don't mind.
Tetufayo.
We don't seek God.
Tetunoonya Katonda.
To find out why He made us put on the flesh.
Okuzula lwaki yatekako omubiri.
Yet I truly believe.
Ate nga nzikiriza
ddala. That that's what a person would do each and every passing day.
Nti omuntu kyasaanidde okukola buli lunaku oluyitawo.
What betide you? If you are serving God ignorantly. Zikusanzi.
Woe unto you.
Okuweereza Katonda.
If you're serving God.
Nga tomanyi kyakwetaaza.
When you don't know what He requires of you.
Nate munange ekyo tukola.
But that's what we do.
We are comfortable with it.
Tuli basanyufu nnyo n'ekyo.
Ate ebyembi, we don't want to relate these scriptures to now which word can I use? Okay, to the last things.
Unfortunately, we don't want to hearken what you are doing to the last things.
Apocalyptic things or eschatological things.
You know when you hear things of the Bible, byenjigiriza.
Ebyoluvannyuma.
Ebintu ebyoluvannyuma.
Mugambe ebyo bijira bituleka.
You say, ah, let those ones pass by us.
No, but then we should prepare you because that time will surely come.
Naye tulina okubateka kubanga bino ebintu birina okujja.
There are things that we have understood.
Waliwo ebintu byetutegedde.
When you look in Matthew 12:36.
Bogenda mu Matayo 12:36.
The Bible tells us.
Bayibuli etugamba.
That God is going to judge us for every idle word.
Nti Katonda agenda tusalira omusango buli kigambo kyonna kye twayogera.
I said Matthew the chapter is 12.
Matayo 12.
And the verse is 36.
No linyoro satumwa mukaga.
But again the Bible warns us in Romans.
Not a baby to love lamba rumi.
The chapter is 14 and the verse is 10.
Esleyo 14 no linyoro 10.
It begins by posing a question to you.
Etandika ngetwe kibuzo.
He tells you, why do you judge your brother?
Ekamba rachi munno msairo msango.
Don't you know?
Tomanyi.
That you will also be judged.
Ogenda salira omusango.
Now we want to understand.
Kakati njagala otegere.
Before we invest a lot.
Ngata tunasiga nyo.
That judgment is sure. Nti okusalirwa omusango jekuli.
The judgment is real.
Jekuli.
It is real.
Banenga Bible bwegamba waliwe ekiseera ky'okuzaalibwa.
As the Bible says there is a time to be birthed.
Mubulizi 3:2.
Ecclesiastes 3:2.
Waliye ekiseera ky'okuzaalibwa.
There is a time to be birthed too.
Naye waliye ekiseera ky'okufa.
But there is also a time to die.
Ate era okufa.
And also death.
Tekirina kirala kinene nnyo kye kiraga.
It has nothing else it showcases.
Naye okufa kutegeeza kwawukana.
But death means separation.
Era ky'ovola abantu waliyo okufa kwa mirundi ng'ebiri oba esatu.
That's why you see there are two kinds of death or three.
There is what they call the physical death.
Walo chebayita okufa kuno kwa buliwo
kwa mubiri. And that's what most of us know.
Era basinga tikwe tumanyi.
That's where the body
awo mubiri
separates from the spirit.
Gweya ula ku moyo.
That's physical death.
Okwo kwe kufa kwa mubiri.
Death is separation.
Ofa kweya ulako.
We talk about spiritual death.
Togera kukufa kwa moyo.
Spiritual death.
Okufa kwa moyo.
Is where your spirit.
Omoyo wo.
Is where your inner man.
Omuntu wo munta.
Is separated from God.
Ayawulibwa okuva Katonda.
Death is separation.
Okufa kwa uliwa.
Then there is what they call internal death.
Walio kwa tuita okufa kwa uluberera.
Now internal death.
Kakati okufa kwa uluberera.
Will be as a result.
Lugenda kuba.
That if physical death.
Kugenda kuba nga chava mukufa kuno kwa uliwo.
If physical death.
Okufa kuno kwa mubiri.
Comes and happens to you.
When you are
spiritually dead,
then
you qualify for internal death.
Can't
them.
Let me revisit it.
The
eternal death.
It's
going to come if the physical death finds
you when your
spiritual body or spiritual man separated with God.
That
means
that
without any cause
you have to
inherit what we've called eternal
death.
But I also want you to understand
that
death means separation. And when they talk about eternal death, they mean
oyawukanidde ddala okuva ku Katonda emirembe n'emirembe.
You've surely been separated from God eternally.
Kati wandibadde awo ng'ogamba.
You would say,
ne bwe mwawukanako.
How if, even if I separate,
ebyo tebirina kye binkola.
They don't do anything to me.
Naye njagala okukakasa.
But I would like to tell you,
abagenda okuyingira okufa kuli okw'oluberera,
those that are going to eternal death,
balina ekifo kye bagenda okubeeramu.
They have a place they're going to be.
Ekifo ekyo Bible bwekyo.
That place when the Bible talks about it is so dreadful. And I also think what has caused that to be people who are stubborn in the house of the Lord. Maybe we've not thought about hell. Sometimes I say, if people could understand what hell is, we would not play with salvation. We would not play with ministry. We would have done whatever it takes to obey the Lord so that we inherit eternal life. But when do we enter that? After we've given accountability. I always give wisdom. You know us as teachers like I read for you in the Bible. The Bible says us as teachers our judgment is going to be beyond this. That's why I decide and I speak the way the things that are meant to be. If I tell you to try and do what the Lord wishes, when you're putting on the body and you feel they are so heavy for you, then I also give you wisdom. If things are heavy, at least start preparing yourself for hell. What is that? There is fire. Start preparing yourself for fire.
Funayo kuliando liteke mukalega. Oli tetenkanye kwegamo hizo kutuka yongo oli combat hardened.
Start preparing yourself. Get coals and put in your body and you know be prepared for fire.
Linya kulianda.
Step on coal.
Lemera koko.
Step on fire and stay there for a moment.
Na yebo obato sobola.
But if you can't,
you are left with no option.
Toina cha kusala
but to determine to do what God requires of you. And I truly believe that's what every Christian should do. That's why he comes out in Matthew. The chapter is 7. And the verse is 21. He says that not all those who come crying, Lord, Lord, shall inherit the kingdom of God. But only those who do the will of God. We have many people in church that are doing, but it isn't about only doing, it's about doing the will of God. If you believe it, say amen. Praise the Lord.
Mukama wafe yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama wafe yebazibwe.
I'm here to remind you.
Ndi wano kujukiza.
That God brought you here for a reason.
Ndi Katonda yakulese wano ku lw'ensonga.
Many of us have reasons.
Abasinga kufe tuyina ensonga.
Remember, God brought you for a reason.
Jukira Katonda yakulese lw'ensonga.
But you also have a reason.
Naye nawe oyina ensonga.
That's why you have chosen.
Yensonga lwaki osazeewo.
To do what you feel like.
Okola ekyo ky'oyagala.
Not to do what God requires of you.
Naye si ekyo Mukama kyakwetaaza.
God came and told Jeremiah, I ordained you to be a prophet. Jeremiah told God,
me
I'm young. He told Isaiah,
Nagamba Isaiah,
I chose you to be a prophet. Isaiah said, if I look at the people I'm with and the way I use my mouth, I cannot serve you. He told Moses, I'm choosing you to be my mouthpiece. And Moses said, I am a stammerer. What reason are you giving? We have many. You tell the uneducated to serve God, they say, me, I'm not educated. You tell the educated to serve God, they say, me, I'm so educated to serve God. Now, who is going to serve God? But then, do you know why we give all those reasons? Because for reasons not known to many of us, we forget the day of accountability. We forget the day we are going to stand at the throne of grace. And that judgment seat. And the person that shall be seated there is going to be a righteous judge. He is going to judge with justice. Meaning that even if he wanted to save you, he will not. Now let me give you something, maybe you'll understand. Just imagine, maybe this is what is going on earth. If
Singa.
You met, which ones? Let's use the city council people who clean the road, who slash the pavements and everything. Now, those ones have been employed
to
slash
okusawa
or to sweep the road. And they have books where they are written that these are the ones who clean this street. Just imagine. If you came here, if you met them,
singa obero wasinkanye,
and you remember that you have a broom,
nojukira nti oyina oreyo,
or a slasher,
oba olusolu sawa,
and you can pick it from your place, and you come and slash, and you come and sweep the road. The question comes, would you be paid?
Bana kusasula.
Would you be paid?
Bana kusasula mukwano.
But didn't you sweep anyway?
Naye tewayeze.
Didn't you slash?
Tewasaye.
Even you may have done it better than those who are employed.
Oyinza kuwa wachikoze nokusinga abali nokikola.
But no payment.
Naye tebagenda kusasula.
Why?
Rachi.
Because you are not organized to do that.
Kubango gwa sigwa mulimo gwo gwe bakuwa.
I want to digress a bit.
Njagala
that many of us are suffering in ministry not because God does not want to pay you, but where your position is not where he positioned you. But we are serving God and people are thanking us. But the question comes back, is that what God prepared? And remember, on the day of judgment, there is nothing that is going to ask you
tewali kigenda kubuuzibwa.
But that that he prepared you to do.
Na yecho kye yakutegekera okola.
My prayer this afternoon.
Okusaba kwange atuntu ya
lero. Is that each one of us.
Ntibulise kino mukufe.
Should take time to go back to God.
Atwaleye akasero kuddayo eri Mukama.
And ask him.
Amubuuze.
And tell him about God.
Amugambe naye Mukama.
What was your intention?
Naje kutali kigenderwa ki?
What was your purpose?
Kutali kigenderwa ki?
That I came here on earth.
Ntinajja waneno.
I just envisage a scenario
where
you have appeared before the throne of God, that judgment seat, and he pulls out his book. In fact, when I'm looking at that day, that day looks like when you go to hospital, because remember, you are going to go there alone. And in hospital, normally you sit on a bench. And then they say next. I'm telling you, I have a feeling. Jesus will say a one next.
Yes, agenda gamba addako.
And no one will go.
We'll tell him
you'll be in your things. And he says, I have said next.
Agambe nti ngambi anaddako.
And it's like there is no next.
Yet
many of us will have not passed there.
Atenga bamu kufe tuinzo kwanga tuise.
But then you'll think about what is going to happen.
Nayo genda kulowoza kwe byebigendo bera yo.
But I'm looking at this bold, majestic person.
Naye tulinda kono omuntu omuvumwe nnyo.
When they tell him next.
Nga bamugamba next addako.
And then he shows up.
Najja nalabisibwa.
He says, yes, Jesus, high five.
Nagamba yes, tufuneko ka high five.
And Jesus is saying no.
Yes, nagamba nedda.
Who are you?
Gwani.
Who are you?
Gwe ani.
And I look at this person.
Let
me use me. And I look at this guy saying, I am Pastor James Mutunzi.
Katinga ntunyo msajo nagamba nze musumba James Mutunzi.
And suppose he asked me,
na ye kantebezenga mbuziza,
who called you to be a pastor?
Do
you think about those things?
Who
told you to join the worship team?
Ania kugamba okweyunga kuba sinza?
Who called you to do what you are doing?
Ania kuita okole chocholi mukola?
I have a feeling because we know how to explain.
Manyinti tumanyo kuoza.
We are ready to explain.
Tulibete gefunyo kuoza.
You see Jesus.
Omanyi Yesu.
Me, I joined the church.
Nzo maina joininga kanisa.
I first joined the ushers.
Nasoka ninegata kubakebezi.
But they were too much for me.
Na yeva alibanji nyo.
So I went to the worship team.
Kakati nengenda mu worship team.
And there I felt that the condition was conducive.
Nempuli.
So I decided to be there. And God will look at his book. And he will say, when I was creating you, I created you to be an intercessor. The accountability I want is about the time you spent interceding. Jesus, auntie, that's what I've been telling you.
Yes, munangi chemba denku gamba.
About the intercession, me, I didn't understand.
Kukwega yanze, sabi tegera ulonji munangi.
So I was in the worship team anyway.
Kae, nalimu worship team.
And even the worship team is serving you, isn't it?
Na ine worship team yaliye kuweza, sicho mukama wange.
And Jesus will tell you, but I created you to be an intercessor.
Yes, agenda kugamba na kutonda okubele omwega ilizi.
The accountability I want.
Embaliza jenja gala.
Is about intercession.
Yeye, kwata gana kukwega ilia.
I see you losing it.
Ndabanga ochivamu.
Telling him, yes, unkunyo nyola totegera. Jesus,
I told you, I was in the worship team.
And still that slothful thinking.
Era mungere yo kulowoza bwotyo.
Eye ndowoza yachejo.
That's a slothful way.
Let me tell you.
Kamba gambe.
This Jesus I'm talking about.
Oh no, Yesu gwemba gamba.
One time he came for a friendly visit.
Oh, nakulumia yaziyeria zokuchara.
Just to meet his friend.
This
guy who lay in his bosom.
Ono mukwano gwe yalinga mu kifuba kye.
Here I'm talking about Apostle John.
Wano njogera ku mutume Yokana.
If you read Revelation.
Bosomo kubikulirwa.
The Bible tells us, and when he turned.
Bible yatugamba na yebo yachuka.
He collapsed.
Nazirika.
He fainted.
Nazirika.
Why?
Rachi.
Because the person he beheld
kubango omuntu gwe yalaba
was different from the one he had lay in his bosom.
Yali wanja ulonyonyo gwe yali yabaddeko naye mu kifuba kye.
Now somehow we have a picture in our mind.
Kakati tuina ekifananye mu ndowooza zaffe.
Of who this Jesus is.
Yesu yani.
Because you find him at Christ the King.
Kubanga omusanga ku Christ the King.
Immovable and calling like everybody.
Buli omu alinga muyita.
You have seen him in films.
Omulabye mu filimu.
And those films, by the way, even he speaks Luganda.
Era ne mwezo filimu Yesu ayogera Luganda.
And when you hear him speaking Luganda, you say, "Eh, njamu nyonyora."
And when you hear him speak Luganda, you will say, "I will explain to Jesus."
But that's not the real one.
Na Yesu yo one na madala.
There is the other one who appears and mountains trot away.
Waliwo oli alabisibwa nensa zinezisetteza.
There is that one who appears.
Waliwo alabisibwa.
And the earth takes off.
Nensi neduka.
Now if you think
kakati wabolo
uza, you are going to reason with that one.
Ntogenda kutesa noyo.
I'm telling you there is a problem.
Kukamba waliwe chizibwa.
There is a problem.
Waliwe chizibu mukwano.
All we have to do
choino kola choka
is to find time now.
Kwe kufuna kasera kati.
And go and seek God.
Ogendo nonye mukama.
Trying to find out what he requires of
us. Okezeko kunonya chicha kwetaza.
I know many of you here may have started losing hope.
Muyinzo kwa mwalimu weddemu esubi.
Ayayaya kale emyaka jona.
Ogamba na all these years.
Yes, we may have begun badly.
Natandise bubi Yesu.
We may have begun badly.
Tuyinzo kwa twatandise bubi.
But then the Bible, if you read in Ecclesiastes 7:8.
Naye bwosoma mu Bibuli 7:8 gamba.
The Bible tells us.
Bible yetu gamba.
That the end of something.
Nti enkomero y'ekintu.
Is better than the beginning.
Esinga nyo entandikwa yechintu.
It is better than the beginning.
Esinga nyo entandikwa yechintu.
And then I truly believe.
Eranzikiriza dala.
We can begin today.
Tusobola okutandika olwalero.
We can begin today.
Tusobola okutandika olwalero.
We can seek God.
Tusobola kugenda tunonya
mukama. We can cry out for him.
Tusobola kumukabirira.
We have organized sessions of seeking God.
Tuina yebisele byokunonya Katonda.
And we have sought him for reasons less than this.
Era tumunonyeza olw'ensonga nga tize zino.
We have sought him for Christmas dress.
Tumunonyeza olw'engo eza Christmas.
We have sought him for Christmas everything.
Tumunonyeza olw'ebintu bya Christmas byonna.
We have sought him for COVID and the like.
Tumunonyeza olwa COVID n'ebintu ebirala.
That I would think.
Naye nandirowoozezza.
It is very important that you seek God, trying to find out what he requires of you. I would like to address the pastors and the leaders, because God has called them. Remember, here I have to go slowly. Remember, we are in the, today it is the pastors leading. And as I address pastors, I'm not addressing pastors of United Christian Center.
Because,
no, so get it.
I'm not speaking to them. Because even the things I'm speaking, they've told them to me. So I would think they know these things. But listen to this. I want to speak to you, a pastor listening to me. There are things.
Why amazing
pastors? The days for the pastors. And I was meant to speak about pastors, but the Spirit led me to go through this.
Let me say this.
Kanjogere chino.
God
Katonda
is not a giver of titles.
Katonda tawa titles eri abantu.
He's not a giver of titles.
Tawa titles eri abantu.
God gives responsibility.
Katonda awabuvunanyizibwa.
And if you fulfill the responsibility, then you qualify to be called the title of the responsibility. And remember, you don't call yourself those who you have served are the ones who call you my teacher, are the ones who call you my pastor. But then what is happening? People have taken titles and absconded from fulfilling responsibility, thinking that if they have the title, then judgment day is going to be about titles. God is not going to ask you about the title. He is going to ask you about the responsibility He gave you. And if you fall short of it, woe betide you. Now, if I want to remind pastors about this. Because for us, that's what we do almost all our lifetime. Why? Because we know if the pastors can stand in their place, if they can do what they are supposed to
do,
then all of us are going to fall in place. I'll give you a testimony. One time I leave this place and go to Mubende. I won't tell you the place, the real place. Now in this place, the pastors in that area, and some of them may be listening, they had organized a joint Greater Mubende conference. It had very many words, big titles, big everything. So, they call me. And they called me because they know I'm a teacher. Anyway, the person who invited me had come here in Kampala and he had me talk in a certain leadership seminar. So he called me. I went to this place. I arrived early. I like being early. So I sat behind and I listened. Then it was lunch time. So when it came to lunch time, I went and introduced myself. Because my sessions, the two sessions, were in the afternoon. So I went to the person who had invited me and I introduced myself. He celebrated. He said, "This is good. Good. So you can also come this way." And then we went for lunch. Now, when we sat for lunch, lunch delayed a bit. So on this table where we are 17 pastors, 16 pastors and one brother. So we sat and they decided to introduce themselves. And they started introducing. People had titles. People had churches. I am Bishop, Apostle, everything this. I have churches that I'm looking after 70 nyinji nyo. And in the end, I said, "What am I going to say?" And unfortunately, or fortunately, they went round like this and I was the last. I thought of walking away. Because what would I say? I'm a married man with three kids. These people are talking about churches. anyway, they came to me. And this is what I said. I said, I am Brother James Mutunzi. Brother, I like calling myself brother. Because I am sure.
Kubanga ndi mukakafu.
I am a brother of Jesus.
Ndi blaza wa Yesu Kristo.
By the even remember. Those titles you have, you are going to give accountability for. Mine is easy. Who called you brother? When I got saved, I became a joint heir. And now I'm a brother.
Katindi wa Luganda.
All about you.
How do you see Jesus? I can't explain
now,
that a lot.
So, when I introduced myself that way, one pastor, still from
Mubende,
he stood up and said, this table is for anointed people. Brothers don't eat from here.
Go
and find where brothers eat from. I saw the pastor who had invited me. He started endeavoring. You see, that's what he wants to call himself. But if it is about titles, he has many. But if it is about you are going to listen to the word, then another pastor stood up and said, then he should apologize for calling himself brother because he's watering down the anointing. And me, I was quiet. Then they said, okay, now it is your turn. Then I stood up. And I told them, okay, now, I'm Reverend James Mutunzi.
Ndi Reverend James Mutunzi.
And they said, are you born again or not? Then I told them, a reverend is a person who gives reverence to God. And that's what I am. Then one of them said, this guy is confusing. And fortunately, the food came and they let me lose. But then as we were eating, I remember then they someone brought up about the topic about the responsibilities of pastors. And as they were talking, I told them, because now I had gained their hearts, now I was going to talk. Then I told them, if you are to be a fully fledged pastor, you must know the 9 responsibilities of a pastor. 9 responsibilities that he is going to give accountability for. Unfortunately, our time is fast
spent.
But I'll try. But this I can. Okay, a pastor is supposed to gather.
Omusumba ino kungana.
Gather what? Sheep.
Kukunganya chi endiga. Chechisoka.
Now these are for the pastor. Now if you are a sheep, you are supposed to be gathered. Kakati. Now when they gather, you don't run away.
Kakati bino bya basumba bayino kukunganya nga gwendiga naye bakukunganya todduka.
And after being gathered, they are supposed to feed you.
Eranga bamaze kukunganya bayino kulisa.
Feed you with what?
Okulisa chi?
The word of God.
Ekigambo kya Katonda.
They have to judicially determine what kind of food each one can take. Then they are supposed to guide. This is where we are passing. They are supposed to direct. Now, why am I telling you their responsibilities? I want that as they impose these responsibilities on you, so that you may not be surprised. They are supposed to protect you. Protect you. Protect what?
Kukuma chi.
Protect the sheep.
Baino kumendiga.
Okay, and the goats.
n'embuzi.
But the goats are elusive.
Naye embuzi zaingira mbuyingizi.
Ziduka.
They run.
You have to tight mark a goat.
Oyina okubeera ku mbuzi.
Ate bwe mbyogera ebyera nzijukirayo n'ekirala.
And when I speak that, I remember other things.
Banange, Pastor Msokiwazi and was talking about his size, that at least now his size can impose. Mumuulide wano.
Did you hear Pastor Msoke talking about his size?
That olusi bwobeera mu size erye tatunda, obonaabona nnyo.
That if you're in a small size that doesn't sell to people, you suffer a lot.
Era nali mu ka size ako, nengena nembuulira, omanyi Bishop oyo atusindika wanja.
And I was also in that size and I went to preach. Bishop sends us to many
and
places.
And that day I was speaking about the people found in church.
Onako na njogera ku bantu betusanga mu kanisa.
I talked about the sheep.
Nenjogera ku ndiga.
I talked about the goats.
Nenjogera ku mbuzi.
And I talked about the wolves.
Nenjogera neku misege.
By the way, as you are here.
Kakati ngo oli wanu.
You are either of the three.
Oli bisatu oli chimu kubisa twebyo.
Either a sheep.
Oli ndiga.
Or a goat.
Oba mbuzi.
Or a wolf.
Oba oli msege.
Kati we njogere chongo gamba amina.
When I speak yours, you say amen.
Now the wolf say amen.
Kakati msege mkamba amina.
They can't even accept. By the way, others don't.
Aba muteba manyu.
So they are waiting for counseling.
Kati balinda counseling. Musumba ndichi. Ndi mbuzi, oba ndi msege.
No, but we're talking about protecting.
Naitogera kukumiwa.
The shepherd is at protect.
Endiga nyangu nyoza kuma.
The goats are hard to protect.
Embuzi nzibu nyoza.
Zikulingize erabu obulira yo.
They look at you and when you surface away, they run.
Adebo zitukeyo jezibuli denga zikabira.
And when they reach there where they've reached, they start crying.
Mumanya embuzi tezeko mya.
You know that ghosts can't bring themselves
back. Kakabira ne kaka kale mwandeze fete mtu vako fe. That's a goat.
They
anyway.
Cry waiting for someone to bring them back.
What the church doesn't want.
E kanisa cheta yagala.
Is rebuke.
Kwe okunenya.
But pastors have to rebuke and that demonish.
Baina okunenya.
They have to.
Baina.
But it's not what
took me there.
There I wanted to go to Hebrews.
The
chapter is
13.
I was
just going through those.
This is what I wanted to leave with
the
pastors. The Bible tells us in Hebrews the chapter is 13. And the verse is 17. This is what the Bible says. Obey those who rule over you and be submissive, for they watch over your souls as those who must give accountability. The key word is must give accountability.
Ntibaino kuembalira.
Accountability on who?
Embalira kwani?
On the people that God has entrusted them with.
Kubantu mukama babe sigisiza.
Those our pastors.
Beba sumba bafe.
After giving all the accountability.
Ngabamazo kuembalira yabo.
They have also to give accountability for us.
Baina noktuwele embalira fengendiga.
And those are some of the things that prevent me from even thinking about being a pastor.
Ebye bintu ebimu ebinziza okulowoza kukubera omusumba n'okubera omusumba.
I really, because now how do I give accountability for a sluggard, slothful person?
Kubanga mpanti embalira ku muntu atafayo nyo.
Very careless.
Ngatafayo.
And then I have to stand and say, you see God, when that guy came.
Nganjogera manyina ngomanyi mukama oyo msajja bwe yajja.
Okay, he came as a goon.
Kale yajanga alibwatyo.
Ngomu yaye. Kale nachuka mnafuka mubi.
And then he became a thief.
Awe yawasa tena atandiko kubo mchala.
And when he got married, he started beating the wife.
Kale nemusabira nakaluba.
I prayed for him and he became hard.
Nwana kutereza byangu.
I'm trying to make right my own thing. And I start explaining things of the others.
Naeba nange, this is what we have to know.
Naishino chetu ino kumanya.
All of us who seek titles and responsibility.
Fena abanonyo vuna njizwa ne title
nene. There is a day. There is that day when we are going to stand before the throne of God. And that day is going to happen when we have come out of our flesh. Who comes out of the flesh? That's the inner man. And now I want us to understand that the inner man comes on earth for a reason and for a specified season, which if you waste,
there is no extension. And if it's that time is over, accountability. And some say, teacher, you don't know something. Ezekiel, turn to the wall. Okay, prepare yourselves to turn to the wall. But he who turned to the wall, how did he finish? If you would look at Ezekiel, you can't even pray to be extended. You can't pray for an extension to do what? I've not yet built my grave. I either want to build it. You know the children are not yet educated.
We are just stewards.
And tuliba weleza weleza.
Tuliba wanika buwanika.
We are just stewards. Do you think you're going to mount these people, you're going to make them rich? When Moses tried, he was the one to lose out.
So this we do this way. We go before God. We seek Him. Telling Him, God. Telling Him, please. Reveal to us what you want us to do. Please, God.
Mukama.
After revealing it. Katinga mazokula gati choli.
After revealing to you what you are, you're responsible
okunonya byolino kola
to seek out for what you have to do. I was telling other pastors in Mubende, when I told them of the 9 responsibilities they have to do, and they told me, which ones are they? You know, those days I was so picky. And I asked, which ones are they? I told them, even you are chasing me from your table of food. And they told me, brother doesn't sit here. And I told them only one reason. That you're going to give accountability for your sheep. You gather them. The food you're giving them is not what they're meant to eat.
I think some
even what
is fed. But now as I close, please, we are going to go and ask God. And God is going to tell you what you want. And after knowing what you want, it is on you to find out the duties that are supposed to be done by you. And make sure you do exactly that. Because you are going to explain. And I wish we were explaining in a closet.
Explain from the closet when we are far away. But we are going to be looking at him straight. I already started imitating how I'm going to be looking before my God. But it's not preparing the eyes, but preparing what the Lord requires you to do.
I truly believe you know exactly what you're supposed to do. And I pray that may God bless you. As you find out what God requires, and you determine by His grace to do exactly that. I beg to hand over because I really have used up my time, but then I believe we should pray. I truly believe. By the way, here in the conference, we don't have enough time. But find time and seek God this time to know what He requires of you. May God bless
you.
Waluo mtu waize?
Is there anyone who has learned something?
Mukama agulumizibwe ndaba temutawa muli speed muone kama wanisiwe muti.
Glory to God.
Chikaka funti o inachoize?
It's an affirmation that you've learned something.
Tongere ngalo omoyo omutukufu.
Let's add the Spirit of God a hand clap.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Ime kubigerebio?
Stand up on your feet.
Manyo budde butu goba?
I know time is against us, but we have to use it profitably.
Tufune worship team.
Let's get the worship team.
Etwaleko mukusinza.
That may take us into worship.
But
amidst worship, you can speak a few words to God.
Obudde bukoese ng'obutono.
Use the time sparingly.
Njakubo chali awan kugamenti atekati kano.
Because as you're still praying, I will tell you we are now done with that session. Time is against us. Tomorrow and Thursday we will be led by the family system. We are still under the theme, the inner man. Accept to be filled with all these days and you will be done well. We have another speaker ahead of time.
I
doubt not at all, because the time he has spent in the field of teaching, he will do you so good.
Musumba Musana agenda kubanga atusomesa.
Pastor Musana will be teaching us.
So tewandi musubidwa.
Therefore, don't miss him.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Sawa lokuwa imesaku mikono jejo maso ga mukama. Musabe yogera ko nebigamba ao masogi. Ngabiva ku mutima omugambe nti nsembeza woli. Biwayo byonna joli. Father, I surrender my life to you. Oh, draw me close to you. Oh, draw me in your praises. Sembeza woli chimugambe nga chiva ku mutima gwo koze se bigambo nga biva ku mutima. I don't want anything else, Jesus. It is you that I want. Gwewe kasobola okunyamba mukama. Gwasobola okukwata ku bukakanyavu bw'omutima gwange mukama. Gwasobola okungonza. Gwasobola okuntaasa. Tonjabulira biwayo byonna joli. Ompite mwagalwa. Zenjayanira gwe Yesu, tewali yomulala. Afayo jendinga kwe. Oh, pumulira mu kwe. Ah, ondage kubo. Elio kwa gala kwa Sembeza woli kampulire kanisa. Sembe zaburi Tonji zaburira Biwayo byonatata
Biwayo byonajo
Kuno mutima gwange nendo zayange Ompite mwagalwa Jayanira kwe Yesu
Jayanira kwe
Chikakasa
Se wali omulala
Teri mulala
Hafaya jendi nga kwe
Pumulira mukwe Ondage kubo Elio kwa gala kwo Yegwe Kwenne taga Jaya nera Kwe mukama Yegwe kwenne taga Emi kono ngoji musiza jari Wati wagamba mchitabwe cha Yeremia Janatu waba sumba ngo mutima gwewe guli
Jayanira we mukama
Yekwe
kwende taga
Yamani yetwe taga Yesu Nyamba Yesu yekwe kwende taga Jayana
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 Yamba tata
Oyimusa emikono gy'egyo maaso ga Mukama n'oyogera naye ebigambo bino. Kirala okubanga Mukama akuwadde omusumba ng'omutima gwe bwe guli naye n'otamutegeera obaolyawo. Yeyama, he pledged that he's going to give us the shepherd according to his heart. Olumu tetubitegeera ebitunoonya bingi naye leero twekwasa mu mukono gwo kitange, leero tugwa mu mikono gyo kitange, twatula nti gwe twetaaga. Abamu twasenguka naye tukomyewo taata. Yamba manye nti woli, yamba manye nti woli. Imuse eddoboozi kimugambe, yamba manye nti oli nange. Yamba manye nti woli, yamba manye nti woli.
Yamba manye nti woli.
Mumbera nyamba, nyamba manye Yesu.
Nyamba manye nti woli,
nyamba manye nti woli.
Nyamba manye nti woli.
Yamba Yesu,
yamba manye nti woli.
Yamba tata,
yamba manye nti woli.
Manye manye, manye manye,
yamba manye nti woli.
Tonta tonta tonta, tonta tata,
yamba manye nti woli.
Yamba
manye nti woli,
mokubula ne mokubula ne mokubula.
Yamba manye nti woli,
yamba manye nti woli.
Yamba
manye nti woli.
Kuyana kwa memeza fe Mukama, olo tuita mumbera ne twebuza obulaba.
Sometimes you go through situations and sometimes you ask ourselves whether you understand what we are going
through.
Help us as we are putting on our flesh. To know that you're here and you're here for us. As it was written that if God is for us, who can be against us? Though I walk through the shadow of death,
yes,
because you are with me, O God.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes,
yes, yes,
yes, yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes.
Yamba manye tiwoli
tata.
nyamba manye tuwole.
Nyamba manye tuwole.
Nyamba manye tuwole.
Nyambire utegerente walingo litamumbere nzibu mulinya lya Yesu.
Amen.
Hallelujah.